Hey there, a huge thank you to all the names on screen right now. The renegades who click the join button down below and contribute to the channel financially. Hugely appreciate that, my friends. If you do enjoy the content, we stream live at twitch.tv/letssuffertogether, but you can also click that like button, subscribe and ring that bell if you want to be notified about when we put out fresh content most days. Enjoy the show, my friends. Hey there, welcome back to Noita. I'm Suffer of Let's Suffer Together back in the mountains, my friends, and oh dearie me, I've got something to show you today. I've been messing around with Infiniwisps. Now, I've already done a video on this explaining how, you know, certain spells in the game can go and continue on existing forever and ever and ever. And just ignore this blood for now. I know it's intriguing and everything, but trust me, we've got about three spells, a few different we've got three or four different concepts to throw at you today. I'll link the previous video in the description, but we're going to cover most of the basics regardless. But hey, feel free to catch up with the previous video where we delve into certain aspects of Infiniwisps. So, well, just have to show you the wiki.gg where we use this chart basically to determine how to modify certain spells to make them have an unlimited lifetime. Like spells like reduced lifetime, increased duration, chain spell, ping pong and orbiting arc are combined. They've both got the same value when it's talking about reducing or increasing the lifetime of a spell. And then you've got phasing, which doesn't really come into many of it. And then you've got the percentage chance of, if firing it, will it occur? Something like, where's the ducks? Where's these ducks? There they are. Ducks have a 0.5% chance. So with certain things, like Omega Black Hole, where you've got a 6.66% chance, you know, you can't make them unlimited, I don't think. And certain spells you just can't make unlimited with the perk. You're going to have to find more inventive ways of trying to get your Infiniwisp. Regardless, that's the basics. And we're going to show you... Game, would you like to please do me a solid? There you go. So firstly, we're going to long distance. I'm going to go through the ones stage by stage. We're going to show off about three or four different concepts today. Firstly, when you are messing around with Infiniwisps, the two spells that are going to help you beyond any shadow of a doubt, they're going to bring everything back to a stable environment. Firstly, Explosive Detonator can explode spells. It can just remove them. It just deletes them. Also, Spells to Power combined with a projectile. These two combined will most certainly remove all projectiles off screen, and it's just handy to have this little setup because Explosive Detonator doesn't work on some Infiniwisps, and I'm not sure about Spells to Power. I use Explosive Det more, but this combination is definitely going to clean up the screen. So I've been wondering, you know, how far can we take Infiniwisps? And one, if they're infinite, can we proc them? Can we bring in an add trigger and then continue on making an Infiniwisp produce an Infiniwisp? Now, I'll show you. Again, as you can see up here, we've got the nice little setup. But firstly, to make a Ukko shot, a Thunder Charge, infinite, you need three reduced lifetimes. Now, you will need to mess around with Divide Bys. So, we need three reduced lifetimes to make the Thunder Charge infinite. And a ping pong. So, when you use a divide by two, it's kind of counterintuitive. This is actually three in total. So if you say use a divide by 10, you're getting 11 things because the boomerang actual spell counts as one and the div 10 gives you 10. So that's 11 in total. So you need to remember that. So we've got three reduced lifetimes, a ping pong. Also, I want this for reasons, right? Just for reasons. And it might be reasons you need as well in your Infiniwisps. I'm going to boomerang this. Now, you can divide by boomerang and make it even more kind of boomerangy, and it's really handy. There's certain things I want to do with this Thunder Charge that require it lasting. Now, just because a spell is Infiniwisp, and this is really important, just because a spell is Infiniwisp, if a spell collides with an entity, aka an enemy, you, or the wall, it can still disappear. So we use Drilling Shot and Piercing to get around that. So no matter what happens, this Thunder Charge is going to last forever. Now, this is what I like to call the Ukko-Core. And it will mess up your audio a little bit, but goddamn, if it's not fantastic. So, this is boomeranging very heavily, of course, the drilling. The drilling and the piercing doing its job there. I'm sorry, guys. But this is what I was doing on stream the other day, and it's just... Oh, it was lovely. It was just such a lovely experience, just to go around, just, you know, not even really kind of recognizing it for myself. You have just become pure power. So that is the basic premise of what we're doing today. We're launching a thunder charge that we can stick to ourselves and proc. You saw it proc multiple times. The explosions is every single frame. Well, it's not. I don't know about every frame. Depends on the tick rate of the actual projectile. So every time this thunder charge touches me, it will explode. And will keep doing so because it's piercing me and it's drilling. Thus, the Infiniwisp won't just delete itself. So, of course, I just use this to delete that then. So, what kind of things can we do with that? Now, I've got no Takasuve, right? I've got none of that. I was thinking, can we make a hel... Hello, dude. Can we make a lot of ones with my Ukko-Core combined with, you know, a nice little Takasuve? Now, you can't, unfortunately, make many ones, but what you can do is literally make it rain. This, I'm gonna leave all this money to the Hisi. He's loving it, you know? So, I'm actually, you can see the money counter, I'm picking up some of it, but it's more just of a novelty. For some reason, I'm not actually making the ones. I wasn't levitating there. I'm not levitating anymore. I am literally killing something to produce money. I'm not levitating at all, right? I'm not pressing any buttons. Right, I've took my hand off the controller. That's pretty sick, innit? I've become a money fountain. If you have gold is forever, yes, you will crash your game. Ah, he's dead. It will, however, once I stop all this. You know, you can pick up some of your money. It should have produced at least one wand. Oh, look at that, a magical liquid. Nice. Yeah, there's one wand around. So, what's happened here is the add trigger has turned my thunder charge into a trigger. Now, word of warning. If you're using divide bys and an add trigger, the divide bys, they need to go before the add trigger. Otherwise, it gets a little screwy. So, just as a, you know, I've put everything before the add trigger. Normally, I'd do it like that, you know, plop it there, get all these spells for free. But because I'm using divide bys and it's just a chunky wand, we don't really need to worry about that. So, you can make a money fountain, for instance. What happens if we try and... Now, the problem is here. This looks really cool. I was trying to make... Because ducks have a 0.5% chance of becoming Infiniwisp. I mean, we have a duck fountain. It's also a duck murder. I mean, it just looks cool. No matter what happens. Now, real problem is, I can't really figure out if any of these ducks become unlimited. I could try and modify it to put piercing or drilling shot. But there's just too much going on, right? You know, this is the problem. You can overload if you're trying to Infiniwisp an Infiniwisp. It is basically a recipe to crash the game. I'm lucky to have a bit of a monster, you know, when it comes to computer. However, I just like the the duck production coming from all this electricity. I mean, it is flooding the entire game with blood, which is, as you'll remember from the very start. Yeah, we got flooded a little bit, but the duck production and... I don't know how viable this would be for attacking regular folk down in the main biomes, but it's a little glorious. Ah, oh, they just disappeared. Oh, there we go. Yeah, this is what I was hoping for. I thought I'd show you all the explosions, because that many ducks on screen when you delete them all, you know, if you try and detonate them all at once, it leaves behind a little blood firework display for you. And this is the kind of Oh, gold should have disappeared by now. Maybe I produced so much gold. Blood firework, yeah. Now, this has to be one of the coolest things I've ever seen. And I've left it until the last remaining little demonstration. This is an unlimited lifetime death cross. Now, it's not really for, much like the ducks, it's not really about having the unlimited lifetime death cross. It's more about the aesthetics of it. And this is just me. I just threw this together in about 10-15 minutes after realizing I could add trigger thunder charges. I literally didn't know what to do for today, and I was like, because I've been feeling really down and ill. Like, I woke up today and I was just like dead. I was operating about 20%. So it's why I'm not on camera normally, for the informational stuff I'm on camera for. No. I'm gone. I'm done. You know, well, I'll be fine for tomorrow probably, but nah, not today. I was just. So anyway, yeah, unlimited lifetime thunder charge, making unlimited lifetime death cross, which we will then detonate. Is it working? We'll do a little roundabout. Oh, you better believe it. We've got pillars. But this is. Oh, yes. I don't know what's actually happening here. I don't know why there's multiple explosions, but if we do it again and try and separate the death cross of it. Yeah, I have given myself a lot of perk, by the way. So you can see the unlimited lifetime death cross down there, just chilling. And we can kind of make lines in them or do whatever we want with them. Now, you could probably make these death cross an add trigger as well, right? You just could probably do that. And do something else with it, and it never ends. You could. Oh, yes. Beautiful. I mean, you could make them rainbow, you could do anything with them. There's a lot of potential in here, especially when you consider, if we go back to this, all of these spells you can make. Unlimited lifetime. What? Unlimited lifetime earthquake? Okay. Holy bomb. Path of the Dark Flame was one we messed around with on stream. That was really cool. Anything that explodes. Giga Black Hole has a 6.66% chance. But as we saw with Takasuve, it gave us money, so it must work on some level. You can use the Greek spells to at least. Not make we didn't try and make the Takasuve unlimited lifetime, but you can at least fire off a thing off an ad trigger with a Greek spell, or it's going to be Greek or a Tau because it's at the end, you know. You can't really use an alpha. Ooh, unlimited lifetime bullet, you know. Stuff is just going to crash and break the game, so do be careful with this. You kind of got to get a little bit inventive. Like, have some good foresight beforehand, because making a rapid amount of certain things, one, will get you killed, shall we say, or it's going to have so many particles on screen, like the infestation, that it's just going to crash the game. Now, with the recent update, that has gotten a bit better, I have noticed. Like, it cuts out the audio, like, as a matter of, I don't know, like, in the most recent update, it seems to cut out the audio a lot more. I'll try and recreate it. Like, if you listen to this, just keep on listening to it. It just, the audio seems, it cuts out, and it just kind of, it tries to protect itself a lot more. Because a lot of the time, if you're rapidly firing something, the audio before the update wouldn't really cut out, and it'll go kind of crackly, and then it'll just break your game. Now it seems to have an emergency kind of, no, shut it down, and restart it kind of deal, until it quiets down. Which is really nice. Yeah, but I hope you've enjoyed this little demonstration and it gets you into more advanced one building. Again, recently, I'm not known for my one building, but getting into it? Oh, I'm getting into it. So I hope you've enjoyed this little demonstration. And I shall leave you, my friends, with the money rain once again. Because, well... I'm sorry. Oh, that does require... Takasuve to be on it. There we go, the money rain. I've got to do this at the top of the pyramid. But, in closing, I've been Suffer of Let's Suffer Together. If you do enjoy the content, we stream live at twitch.tv/letssuffertogether. This Saturday on the 25th, we're doing a 24-hour meditation stream in the cauldron. It's going to be amazing. You know, any excuse to do anything but Noita, that is. You know, we'll have Noita on the corner just standing in the cauldron, and it will find ways and means of doing absolutely everything. For the 24-hour period... Hey, money rain! But thank you for taking the time to enjoy the content. If you want to, dropping a like, subscribing always helps the channel. Gets out there, helps me out. Helps you out, maybe. In bit, like, you know, further videos down the line. I've put my controller down. I'm going to space! Oh, yeah. This is the permanent levitation Ukko-Core money production facility. Oh yeah, man, I never knew I was actually levitating more. I thought I was just not falling. Oh, that's beautiful. Ah. Hey, if you have any great ideas and want to, like, because this is part two, maybe there'll be a part three if we see some really, like, big improvement on some good ideas or something really fresh. Any ideas, get down in the comment section. But it's been an absolute pleasure, my friends. I'm glad I can bring something like this, you know, to the forefront. And, yeah, I'll be taking it easy. I wanted an easy night, you know. And luckily, I had the blueprints for these in my mind for a while. So, it's a pleasure. And, I'm going to go down, stretch, and lie down, and recover fully for tomorrow. You take it easy, guys. Enjoy the rest of your day wherever you are in the world. And, hey, keep on noiting, you know. Just keep on keeping on. Into space, you know, or wherever you want to go. Hey, but with this kind of technology, you're gonna go in many places. I'll see you soon, guys. Much love. Peace.